Iran's retaliation for the United States' targeted killing of its top general is likely to include cyber attacks, security experts warned Friday. Iran's state-backed hackers are already among the world's most aggressive and could inject malware that triggers major disruptions to the U.S. public and private sector. Potential targets include manufacturing facilities, oil and gas plants, and transit systems. A top U.S. cybersecurity official is warning businesses and government agencies to be extra vigilant in 2012 and 2013, in response to U.S. sanctions. Iranian state-backed hackers carried out a series of disruptive denial-of-service attacks that knocked offline the websites of major U.S. banks, including Bank of America as well as the New York Stock Exchange and NASDAQ. 2 years later, they wiped servers at the Sands Casino in Las Vegas, crippling hotel and gambling operations. The destructive attacks on U.S. targets ebbed when Tehran reached a nuclear deal with the Obama administration in 2015. The killing early Friday in Iraq of Quds Force Commander General Qassem Soleimani, long after Trump scrapped the nuclear deal, completely alters the equation. "Our concern is essentially that things are going to go back to the way they were before the agreement," said John Hultquist, director of intelligence analysis at the cybersecurity firm FireEye. "There are opportunities for them to cause real disruption and destruction. Iran has been doing a lot of probing of critical U.S. industrial systems in recent years trying to gain access, but has limited its destructive attacks to targets in the Middle East," experts say. It's not known whether Iranian cyber agents have planted destructive payloads in U.S. infrastructure that could now be triggered. "It's certainly possible," Hultquist said, "but we haven't actually seen it." Robert M. Lee, chief executive of Drajos Inc., which specializes in industrial control system security, said Iranian hackers have been very aggressive in trying to gain access to utilities, factories, and oil and gas facilities. "That doesn't mean they've succeeded, however. In one case, in 2013, where they did break into the control system of a U.S. dam, garnering significant media attention, Lee said they probably didn't know the compromised target was a small flood control structure 20 miles north of New York City.